Good evening, everybody. I'm meteorologist Haley Lapointe. Here's an update on your wet forecast. We've got another batch of rain just about to move in. Already starting to see light to moderate rainfall along the western half of the state. This whole batch about to shift eastward. This has been a pretty massive system with areas of very heavy rainfall and even a couple of tornadoes that have touched down in the southeastern part of the U.S. today. So thankfully, we're not seeing that type of weather. It's just going to be some rain, maybe a few rumbles of thunder overnight tonight and early on Monday. We'll get one more shot at some mild air tomorrow as this system moves through. We'll kind of squeeze out some of this milder air you see down toward Cleveland, but then it does get much colder. In fact, it's been snowing out by Chicago where temperatures are in the 30s. So we won't get quite that chilly, but temperatures will drop, especially by the time we get to Tuesday and into Wednesday as well. So through the evening hours and overnight, the rain begins to fill in and starts to become a bit more steady. And tomorrow morning, I think by about 7 a.m., there will likely be downpours moving across the area. And this is when there could be a few rumbles of thunder. That's certainly possible. And it continues into the morning, though I think by midday, there might be a little bit of a break in the action, which is great news for the marathon going on course down by Boston. So there might be some peaks of sunshine, and this is when the temperatures will get their big boost. Some southern areas getting back into the mid, maybe even upper 60s. There will be some more scattered showers and downpours into the afternoon, so we're not totally done with the wet weather in the morning. Another round is likely into the afternoon and evening. Then finally, this system gets on out of here by about 7, 8 o'clock. And then we're back to sunshine for Tuesday. And yes, there could be a little bit of mixed showers or even some snow in the North Country during the day on Tuesday, but little to no accumulation likely. As far as rainfall amounts go, certainly it's going to be a healthy dose of rain, especially where we get some of those pockets of the heavier rainfall. And there could be a few areas that get upwards of an inch, especially into Lebanon and Plymouth. And those areas in central and northern New Hampshire where there is still some snow on the ground, that coupled with the rain and the snow melting means that there is the possibility of some minor river flooding. So a flood watch has been posted through Monday and into early Tuesday for those central and northern areas. Tonight, temperatures coldest north in the upper 30s there, but most of us will actually be landing in the 40s overnight, probably as mild as 50 in Nashua, down into Jaffrey and in Keene with the rainfall. Tomorrow, very mild if you're in Manchester down into Nashua, but even much of the rest of the state will likely at least hit 60 degrees. But we're back to cooler temperatures, probably a good 10 degrees cooler than this by the time we get to Tuesday. For the Boston Marathon, if you know runners, if you are a runner, congratulations. This is a huge thing for you to be doing, and we're all going to be cheering you on here in New Hampshire. For the starting line, that's when the heaviest rain is going to be moving through. And there could even be some rumbles of thunder, temperatures in the 50s. But by noontime, the rain becomes much more scattered. It actually will stop for a time. Maybe the sun peeks out. The thing then will be the warmth, with temperatures in some spots approaching the upper 60s. Tuesday and Wednesday, colder for us with temperatures in the 50s. Be breezy on Tuesday too, by the way. Wednesday, sunny. And then it gets very unsettled through the end of the week and into next week. Weekend with a lot of showers. It won't be raining that entire four-day stretch you see there, but lots of on and off showers, lots of clouds, and temperatures hanging out mainly in the 60s.